actually know your liver? Would you like to learn more about its anatomy, tasks and functions in your body? Then be sure to stay tuned now. Where is your liver actually located? The liver is located in the upper right part of your abdominal cavity, below your diaphragm and above your stomach, right kidney and intestines. What shape is the liver and how much does it weigh? It weighs about 3 pounds. The liver is shaped like a cone and is dark reddish brown in color. It also consists of two main lobes, which in turn consist of 8 parts, which are made up of 1,000 lobes. There are two different sources that supply your liver with blood. Oxygen-rich blood flows in from the hepatic artery and nutrient-rich blood flows in from the hepatic portal vein. But what functions and tasks does your liver perform for you now? The liver regulates most chemical levels in the blood and secretes a product called bile. Your liver includes as a partner, the organ the gallbladder. The common bile duct transports the bile produced by the liver cells, through the common bile duct into the gallbladder and your duodenum. This is the first part of your small intestine. Bile is made by your liver and stored in your gallbladder. It is important for you to get fat-soluble vitamins like vitamin A, E, D and K, to be absorbed and processed. Waste products are removed through it and fats are broken down in the small intestine during digestion. All the blood that leaves the stomach and intestines passes through your liver, which then processes the blood. It also splits, balances and creates nutrients and metabolizes toxins and medications as well. Your liver performs up to 500 vital functions in your body. These include the following: production of certain proteins used in the formation of blood plasma, production of cholesterol and special proteins to effectively move fats around the body. Excess glucose is converted to glycogen and stored. Glycogen can later be converted back to glucose for energy. Regulation of blood levels of amino acids, which are the building blocks of proteins. Processing hemoglobin to use its iron content. Your liver stores iron, by the way. Converting toxic ammonia into urea. Good to know, urea is an end product of protein metabolism and is excreted in your urine. Produced immune factors, fend off infections and bacteria are effectively removed from the bloodstream. Another important task, regulating blood clotting. The healthier your liver, the better wounds heal. Bilirubin is an important factor. Some people may experience yellowing of the skin and eyes because the liver also balances bilirubin. If its function is disturbed, for example in the case of fatty liver, these phenomena occur. Bilirubin is a bile pigment that is formed during the breakdown of red blood pigment, also called hemoglobin. It then binds to the protein albumin. This is called indirect bilirubin, which then reaches the liver. The byproducts of your bile enter your intestines and are then excreted in the form of feces. The byproducts of your blood are filtered by your kidneys and excreted in the form of urine. The liver regulates hormone balance. Hormonal imbalance may indicate impaired liver function. Your liver itself does not produce hormones, but breaks them down, such as the stress hormone cortisol and testosterone and of course estrogen. Estrogen is released by the liver into bile acid and the bile acid now flows through your digestion to your intestines. When you eat high fiber, you reduce the amount of estrogen in the bile acid. Especially for menopausal women, a healthy, functioning liver is of great importance. If there is a problem with the breakdown of the liver during the menopausal cycle, hormone dominance will result. It also performs the special task of converting 60% of the inactive thyroid hormone T4 into the active form T3. Likewise, the hormone vitamin D is converted in the liver into the active form vitamin D3. How are your kidneys structured and what tasks and functions do they perform for you? Find out in the next episodes. Quote of the day: if you know the history of your organ, you know how to keep it healthy.